In this segment, we'll talk about a real-life problem of setting up simultaneous linear equations. Let's suppose somebody gives you a velocity of a rocket as a function of time. The rocket is going in upward motion, in a straight line, let's suppose. And we're given the velocity of the rocket at different times. This is 5, 8, and 12. And the value is given as 106.8. 177.2 meters per second and 279.2 meters per second. And one of the questions which people might ask you about when somebody gives you velocity versus time data at discrete data points, finite number of points, is that, hey, can you find out what the value of the velocity is at some point, let's suppose 6 seconds or so, or 9 seconds or somewhere in between 5 and 12. And one of the ways to do it is to simply draw a straight line between, let's suppose, two consecutive points. Like if somebody's asking you to find the velocity at 6 seconds, you might say, okay, hey, I'm going to take these two points, draw a straight line, and find out what the value of the velocity is 6 seconds. Or if somebody, let's suppose, asks me to find the velocity at 10 seconds, I can always draw a straight line between these two data points and be able to figure that out. So, but let's suppose somebody says, hey, no, you got to do better than a straight line. So if we plot these points on a piece of graph paper, so we got velocity here and time here. So velocity at 5 is given as 5, 106.8. That's the coordinate there. Then at 8, it is 177.2. And then at 12, it is 279.2. And what somebody's asking you is that, hey, I want you to draw a second order polynomial. I want to have a velocity profile or a velocity curve, which is a second order polynomial, which is going through these three points. So in that case, if we are going to call that velocity profile or velocity curve to be at squared plus bt plus c, that's our second order polynomial, which is going to approximate the velocity from t equal to 5 to 12 seconds. So our velocity profile, or what we call as an interpolant also, will be at squared plus bt plus c, 5 less than equal to t less than equal to 12. Because whenever you want to write an interpolant for discrete data, it has to be also, what has to be given is the domain in which that particular interpolant is valid. So the question is that if I can find out what this velocity profile is, then I'll be able to find the velocity at any point between a time t equal to 5 and time t equal to 12 seconds. So the question arises, hey, how do I find out A, B, and C? But the thing which we're seeing here is that this velocity profile, the second order polynomial velocity profile, is going through three points. So that's going to help me set up the three equations. So what I mean by that is that, hey, if I say the velocity at 5 is given by A times 5 squared plus B times 5 plus C, but what is the velocity at 5? It's 106.8. And what is the velocity at 8? It'll be A times 8 squared plus B times 8 plus C is equal to 177.2. And what is the velocity at 12? It is A times 12 squared plus B times 12 plus C is equal to 279.2. Now if I make the simplification here, the first equation which I have here will become 25A plus 5B plus C is equal to 106.8. Then the second equation, which is right here, will become 64A plus 8b plus c is equal to 177.2. The third equation, which is right here, will be 144a plus 12b plus c is equal to 279.2. So what I have are three equations and three unknowns. So this is my first equation, this is my second equation, this is my third equation. So I have three equations and the three unknowns are a, b, and c. So this is an example, real-life problem of setting up simultaneous linear equations. So we got three equations and we got three unknowns. And if we are able to solve these three simultaneous linear equations, we'll be able to find the values of A, B, and C. And once we know what the value A, B, and C is, we have the velocity profile or the velocity curve from time t equal to 5 to time t equal to 12, hence be able to find the approximate value of the velocity at any other time other than 5, 8, and 12, which is already given to us. And that is the end of this segment.